Hello, and welcome back to the Banker's Masterclass series on leveraging the hybrid cloud in association with Red Hat and Tata Consultancy Services. I'm Joy McKnight, Managing Editor at The Banker, and I'm joined by Red Hat's Ramón Villarreal and Kishore Banavar from TCS. In the third chapter of this Masterclass series, we'll be taking a deeper dive into specific use cases around enhancing payments. Ramón, how can hybrid cloud really enhance and extend payments across industries?
The payments market is actually evolving really deeply at the moment, and it's actually one of the areas within the financial services industry that is getting more disruption, especially because a lot of the new entrants, the way that they are coming to the market is by enabling new abilities of pay, new ways of interacting with the customer. At the same time, the customer is asking for these new capabilities and a higher flexibility in the way that they get services, a new type of services that maximize the value and simplify the way that they transact. We are moving into a world of the cashless economy, and the ability to actually deliver that type of services is becoming a bigger priority. So for financial services institutions that are looking to actually deliver that value to the customer whilst maintaining the level of resilience and scalability that is needed for transactional processes such as payments, and you know, nobody wants to lose those, hybrid cloud provides the native solution to start building those capabilities. It actually enables the innovation that is needed to actually cater for those client needs. But it also brings you the connecting point on resilience and scalability and automation, and brings new paradigms of maintaining that scale that is needed to participate in the market. So it's actually something that is natural, and most of the financial institutions globally are looking to leverage.
The payment or any kind of money movement within an industry or across industries has been going through unprecedented transformation. In fact, payment is the only main glue that connects industries such as banking, retail, insurance, and so on. So be it the explosion of digital and real-time payments, or even shortening of cycles of cross-border payments or settlements, all the major countries are looking at modernizing and readying their platforms for the future of payment industry. So due to the distributed nature of payment value chain, or very high scalability needs, or sometimes even seasonal peaks, or intolerance to any kind of failures or outages, or a need to integrate with various industry and cross-industry players, and also some new opportunities to establish and leverage payment analytics and so on, all the factors are driving a need for a very robust kind of a cross-industry platform, and hybrid cloud models are expected to address that.
How does a more flexible infrastructure help banks adapt to the changing expectations of customers?
The payment market and those expectations of the customers are becoming global, and the scale and the demand of new capabilities is actually putting pressure in the systems at the moment. They have like flexibility and the ability to migrate, but also to scale up and down that infrastructure, gives the banks the ability to actually build the systems that are reliable enough to deliver the value that the customer needs. At the same time, those infrastructures are designed in natively for automation. Therefore, they enable the ability of releasing capabilities faster into the market, which is exactly what the customer is asking. So for example, we are working with some financial institutions at the moment that they are basically building new capabilities in terms of paying or interacting with customer, QR code payment through identification, et cetera, and those capabilities are basically native and intrinsically generated with a hybrid and flexible infrastructure.
And how is hybrid cloud enabling this modernization drive?
Each of the elements of the payment value chain, starting from initiation all the way up to the final settlement, is as it is quite complex. in the future, it is going to be further more complex in terms of the processing. It is expected to be more distributed with many more players and capture points coming in, maybe for loyalty or marketplaces or offer ecosystems, connected payments, payments initiated by IoT devices, wallets, and so on. So both the major processors as well as the niche players here, they need to adopt some combination of hybrid cloud for meeting business obligations with the required quality of service and economic viability. Of course, based on our current conversations with various players, major banks, central payment infrastructures, including network processors, are taking a very cautious and measured approach towards cloud adoption. Of course, they are making incremental steps. However, many payment processor packages are being made available in a SaaS model, so which can be directly consumed. So, in many ways, for various players, the hybrid cloud definitely caters to this modernization drive.
Many thanks for your insights, Ramon and Kishore. In the final chapter of this masterclass series, we'll be looking at open banking and the ecosystem approach.